less than 2 hours from the south of Mexico City, is a mysterious, low-profile town that is located in the state of Mexico.
Tucked away between the Trans-Mexican Volcanic Belt and the Sierra Norte, this town has always been associated with magic or sorcery due to the legend that it was the home to the goddess Malinalxóchitl. With all the magic here, it's no surprise that this is another one of Mexico's Pueblos, Mágicos.
This is Malinalco.
Welcome back to Tourist to Local. We hope you guys enjoyed our last week's video in Toluca.
Yeah, it was a fun place, but right now we're in a Pueblo Mágico called Malinalco, still in the Estado de Mexico.
This Pueblo Mágico is awesome. It's a great day trip for those who live in Mexico City, and there's a lot of interesting facts about this place that we're going to share with you guys later.
But first, we have to eat. Actually, our friends are waiting for us.
Let's go. Breakfast, we headed to the town center to a little restaurant called Marimali. We caffeinated, came up with a game plan for the day, and dug into a delicious Mexican breakfast. I got the itacate dish, which came with tacos dorados, sopes, and tostadas, and Martin got the huevos Marimali, which was a nice light option with eggs served on top of some cactus.
After, it was time to explore. On Sunday, Malinalco is alive. The town center turns into a large open-air market where you can grab some food or some artisan craft. Pueblos Mágicos are notorious for having great artisan goods, so it's no surprise that Malinalco has a lot to offer as well.
As you walk around, you'll quickly run into the parish of El Divino, Salvador. And if you're wondering why you haven't seen any clips of us talking here, our audio failed during this trip, but here's a clip we were able to somewhat recover.
Completely beautiful because right now, after the rainy season, it's all green and you can see all the mountains around completely green and beautiful. It's beautiful. You want to just sit next to a tree and just like
eat a guayaba.
Be here the entire day and eat a guayaba. That's right. That's exactly what I wanted to do, Julian. So you can keep recording. I'm gonna stay over here, and whenever you finish, just you can find me over here.
Perfect.
Now, I feel like I'm having deja vu because you guys may remember a few months, actually, I think over a year ago, we recorded in Tepoztlán, which is another Pueblo Mágico in this area. And this feels like a kind of small version of that. Of course, we have beautiful church, we got the market surrounded by mountains. There's even an archaeological site we can climb to. It's giving me Tepoztlán vibes, which I love. That town is amazing. And there's actually some interesting facts about how this town is related to that one. We're going to tell you guys about it.
Tepoztlán, Xochicalco, and Malinalco mysteriously all line up in an almost perfect triangle. And this place gets spookier. We'll talk about this in a bit, but in the meantime, it's time for ice cream. There's an ice cream company called Malinalli that we kept seeing everywhere.
They have unique flavors like fig and mezcal, cheese and blackberries, and what Juliana chose, churro.
Right now, we're going to the archaeological site. Not fun, but it will be fun whenever we're in the top.
High above the town are the Aztec ruins of Quantinchan, which is where we headed next. And to get there, we have to walk 426 steps, just like they did in the old days.
Yeah, the guards told us we have 20 minutes before they close. On Sundays, they close at 2. Nothing like that threat to really get you to move fast and persevere. We barely stopped. And I have no idea if we're close. There's a song that is in my head to keep me inspired. It goes like this. No pares, sigue, sigue. No pares, sigue, sigue. And I'm doing just that.
At
the top lies one of the most impressive monolithic structures in Mesoamerica, the House of Eagles. This was once the site of numerous important rituals, including the initiation for eagle and jaguar warriors. While it's hard to make it out today, this was once one of the most elaborate entrances found in Aztec architecture. The door was shaped like the mouth of a serpent, and beyond its entrance was where the bloody ceremonies took place. Now, remember the perfect triangle we talked about earlier? Well, the legend is still prevalent among local communities that this creates some strange magnetism and unexplained phenomena at certain times of the year. To this day, many people report suffering from dizziness, nausea, and even fainting upon approaching the hill we're on now.
We're a little dizzy and nauseous ourselves, but it just may be from eating too much ice cream before this hike. But that's not anything a little beer can't fix.
After that hike, my God, we sweat. So we deserve a little treat. So right now we're having our beer with Ajonjolí over here. So cheers.
We hope you guys enjoyed coming to Malinalco with us and exploring the state of Mexico the past few weeks.
It's a beautiful little town over here in the Estado de Mexico, but we have to go to our next adventure.
Yeah, so we'll see you in the next one. So long.
Travel well.
And make the world your neighborhood. See you guys next time.
Bye. Bye.
Curious what camera gear we use while traveling? Want to rock some of our awesome merch? Or maybe you just want a discount with some of our favorite companies? Make sure to check out the description of this video for links to all these things and more.